Welcome to Caliente Topics. This is your daily tax webcast. My name is Veronica Russell from MMTAXMAN.com, and I have Patrick Russell, EA, as well from MMTAXMAN.com. Good morning, Patrick. Happy Friday. Finally, it's a Friday. So what's the topic for today?
How you doing, Veronica? Yes, today, guys, we're going to be talking specifically to you do-it-yourselfers that are sole proprietors that are running a business out of their home. We're specifically going to be talking about when you make improvements onto your home office and whether or not you can depreciate those costs and whether or not do many people take advantage of this line item. The answer to first one is yes. You absolutely can depreciate your home office and the improvements on the home office. Now keep in mind that we are talking about the square footage, specifically the square footage of the house that's used exclusively for the business, in comparison, the denominator being the square footage of the entire interior of the home, right? Now, and the reason why that's important is because you then have to take that allocation and then spread it across how many years do you depreciate on a home office? Go for it.
39 years.
That's exactly right. It's not considered a residential rental, which is typically depreciated with a 27.5 useful life. A home office would be considered a commercial office, which would fall into the 39-year category. So not only are you being concerned with allocating the cost of the improvement directly based on square footage of use of the business to the rest of the house, which could generally be ballpark between, 10-15% of the total cost, but now that figure also has to be cut in 39 ways to justify the useful life of 39 years. That's how it works, the recovery period being 39 years, how long it would take. So, long story short is that these costs, because of these limitations and allocations, become a very small line item, right, in most people's, you know, homes and improvements to their homes. And even though this number is a line item off of Schedule C, which is self-employed income, so it does save you self-employed tax at a rate of 15.3%, wonkers out there. But then you have to balance the benefit of what you lose. Section 121, home sale exclusion. Let's go with the basics first. Softball question, Veronica. What is the exclusion off of a home sale for singles and for married, filing, joint?
Definitely. So single, it's $250,000, and married, filing, joint will be double, which is $500,000.
That's exactly right. So the IRS Code Section 121, home sale exclusion, allows you as a single person to exclude up to $250,000 of capital gain.
Yep.
Right? So it's not the sales price, but when you do the calculation, if there was a gain, $250,000 is tax-free. You don't pay a dime on that. And, of course, what she had mentioned, married, filing, joint, double that to $500,000. Now, if you choose to take depreciation on your home office, keep in mind that you will then limit and lose some of that Section 121 protection. Why? Because whatever depreciation expense you had claimed throughout the years of ownership and use in the business, you then have to recapture that in the year of disposition. So keep in mind that taking the home office depreciation is a current year benefit, but it is, in many wonkers' view, just really a lump, right? Because then when you dispose of the property down the line, you now have to take into account what you took as a depreciating expense, because the government wants you to recapture that.
Yep.
And then so now you start losing some of that tax-free protection that you were always hoping for and planning on based on the Section 121 exclusion. Does that make sense? So now,
yes, definitely.
The reason why most clients, depending on the line item amount, obviously the amount would dictate how forceful a client really wants to take and make use of this line item, this home office depreciation deduction, most won't. Right, because they balance the very minimal amount of the current year expense versus the administration and the tax filing, extra forms, extra worksheets, extra maintenance of trying to keep that running total and on your basis worksheet correct. It doesn't sometimes balance out. The good benefit versus the cost typically doesn't balance out in the minds of the clients. And so typically they choose not to take anything but the simplified home office deduction, which allows you to take a percentage of the use of all of the home's office expenses on a monthly basis, but based on a square footage straight line allocation, no depreciation involved. You're allowed to take some of that cost, being able to recapture it through that simplified method. And most people will rely on that and generally will bypass and forego depreciating the home office for what we had talked about, the minimum benefit provided, Social Security taxes, self-employed taxes. Yeah, you would have a benefit of reducing it on a current year basis, but you have to balance that out versus all of the other factors that I had brought up. And it is the reason why most people typically won't depreciate their home office. Questions on your end?
No, I think you said everything. And I mean, we have a lot more information, so we're going to come back with another webcast in the next few days.
A quick way to get a quick answer is by using the comment box below. Guys, don't just subscribe to this channel, even though we will be doing this pro bono tax workshop on a daily basis, but lend your voices to the show. It'll make it a whole lot more interesting. Guys, have a great weekend. We'll talk to you on Monday.